I think International Women's Day is a perfect moment in time, you know, to really celebrate what we've achieved as a sport over the last 12 months or so, since the last International Women's Day, I guess, but also not only to reflect on that and celebrate it, but I think to set some even more ambitious goals for us as a sport and how we engage with women and girls in all sorts of parts of the game. I think last year was, you know, it was a year of firsts in many ways, which is something to be really proud of, everyone at the ECB to be proud of. We had the first instalment of professional contracts for 18 members of the England women's team when they came back from their back-to-back Ashes wins down under. We then, just shortly thereafter, announced a groundbreaking deal with Kia Motors as the first standalone commercial partner for England women's cricket. And alongside all of that, you know, a game in its rosiest state at grassroots level. So we celebrated 1 million girls going through the Chance to Shine programme. And I think, you know, in terms of longevity, that's, I think, something we should all be really proud of, that the sport is more accessible to girls than ever before. And culturally, we're all working in a sport that is attractive to girls who see it as a viable option, you know, who maybe prior to opportunities through Chance to Shine didn't think cricket was even an option for girls and it was purely a boys' sport. So I think there is lots to be proud of, and I think it gives us a great platform on International Women's Day to really think where do we want the game to go, where do we want women's cricket globally and within this country to sit, and you know, what's everyone's role in that going to be.
International Women's Day is a really good reference point for us to check our progress on women's cricket. We've made some progress in this area, but we've got a lot more to do, and I think we're really only scratching the surface in terms of our potential in this area. It's a huge part of our drive for participation across the game to get more women and girls playing cricket and involved in cricket in different ways. So we only see great things happening going forward, and obviously continued success for our international team.
Professional contracts have changed the game massively. I think in the last year I've seen how the game's grown, and obviously in my time of playing 18 years, it's been quite unbelievable the changes that I've seen. And you know, to think now that I'm paid for playing and I have a career, and the fact that, you know, many of the girls now have as a career option, you know, to go and tell a young primary school child that, you know, there is a career in cricket is a very powerful thing to be able to tell someone.
I think as well on International Women's Day, it's a great time to actually look at what the England and Wales Cricket Board has achieved for women and girls in cricket. And I think what's really pleasing is culturally there's been a huge shift over the last 10 years or so, but significantly I think over the last couple of years, where everybody within the organisation is really galvanised behind the game for women and girls, and sees it as a really core part of what we do. Whether it's coaching, whether it's marketing, whether it's in the commercial team. I think there's a really strong sense that there's huge potential for our sport with women and girls, whether to attract more talent to work in the sport, whether to attract more talent to play the sport, or just to give every girl the opportunity to have a go at it.
It's been an incredible journey to watch the game grow and to see how, you know, how many now young girls are playing the sport and enjoying it, and to have played a small part in that is you know, really special for us.
For the first time, every game's going to be live on Sky for the Ashes series this summer, so that's an exciting development and just shows the massive strides that the women's game has made to now being a bona fide broadcast product in its own right. And we're very, very excited about the women having a greater sense of exposure in the summer to wider audiences across broadcast and across our digital channels as well. So it's a nice development, and it's nice to see our commercial partners supporting all our international teams. Absolutely, it can. I mean, there's you know, it's going to be a massive summer for all our international teams, but our women's team, we've got some seriously high hopes for them. They've just had some, an interesting topsy-turvy tour in New Zealand. But we're expecting them to go really well against Australia this summer.